That tour was really interesting, don't you think?
It was me who created this wonderful town, but now I have to destroy it.
And I want to invite you to visit Lorelai. It's a beautiful, forever-blooming town. Well, at least it used to be. All our familiars are affected by a disease. Nobody understands what's happening or how to cure them. Since you're a great tamer who knows animals best, maybe you'll manage to remedy this? Also, I know you keep your own bestiary, so I've made a new one for you with a description of the local fauna. Please come to Lorelai. Lots of love, your sister, Celestia.
Hello, I'm Virgil, the ruler of this town. I believe you're here to save the day. We need to stop this disease, as almost everyone here has a helping hand in the form of a familiar. Celestia buried herself in the ancient folios, trying to figure out the nature of the disease. Her familiar has caught it too. Don't be afraid. This disease does no harm to a human being. Also, there are no other towns in the vicinity. So we have to deal with the situation on our own. You'll need to get a special document to move freely around Lorelai. I have to leave you now. There is business to attend to. See you later.
Oh, hello. I'm sorry. It's all because of the night shifts. You know, the monsters are usually awake at night. Well, let me tell you about our town a little. Our peaceful life ended when those monsters invaded our homes and killed our children and animals. We sank into despair. Even the sun seemed to be paler. We had to retreat. We did manage to survive and grow a stem big enough to found a town on it. It took several days for the stem to reach the bird's habitat. Its roots were deep enough to go up safely. live and flourish under this beautiful sky. The monsters are still down there, but we'll find a way to fight them and go back to the forest. Nature will revive and return its bright colors. Certain rules help keep everyone safe. Under no circumstances should anyone go down, especially at night and without any weapons. There's only the slimmest chance for an adventurer to survive. Here, take this amulet. It'll help you to open the gates.
So glad you've made it here. And I've prepared a welcome gift, the new bestiary. I added descriptions of the local fauna for you to read. I'm sorry I couldn't meet you. You see, my familiar, Fitz, has been acting strange lately. He never used to be such a loner. He barely comes up to me. The bestiary must be somewhere in my stuff. Please find it. Thank you. That's exactly the disease I was talking about in my letter. You've just witnessed its final stage, aggression. I need your knowledge of magical creatures to get to the root of the problem. My home is your home. Feel free to take anything you may need. I'll be waiting inside.
Thank you.
great. I've never doubted your ingenuity. Now we know what caused these troubles. Sly Fern Dew. Who would have thought? Ferns like these grow at the roots of the stem the town is on. We can use a magic hot air balloon to get down there. It needs a bit of fixing, though. I'm sure you can handle it. You'll find the balloon in the yard. I'll go and fetch everything. I'll need to take samples. Here, take this plant encyclopedia. I was meant to give it to you a long time ago, but better late than never. Meet you by the balloon. How he poisoned the water in the town. Poison goes up to the water supply system, fills all the buds. Familiars drink it and fall ill. Please tame his wolf. With its help, we may be able to trace the intruder. This is a magic wolf. It must have an excellent sense of smell. We must use it to our advantage. Please have a look around. Maybe we'll be lucky enough to find some of that person's stuff for the wolf to send him. I'll look after this beautiful creature, just in case it decides to have a little walk. Perfect! The wolf's got a scent. Let's go after him. We can't let him get away. Look for another way to get here. I'll try to catch up with this bad man. Thank you once again. I walked into the trap just as I was about to catch him. He was so close. Rumor has it Virgil's agents saw someone in this area, but there was no evidence to be found. That's so sweet! I've missed the way you care about me. It sounds terrible, but I'm grateful that this misfortune has happened. The investigation is the reason you are here. By the way, I've never been so far away from Lorelai. The townspeople say that there is a magic lake somewhere around here. Look into it, and you'll see the future. Ugh, this trap thing cost me a few bruises and cuts. I need to take care of them. Don't wait for me. There are important things requiring your attention. Here, you may need it.
Your destiny is now in the hands of the ruler of the Wildlands.
Hello, I'm Septimia, a refugee from the Town of Dreams, and also a former court alchemist. The severe drought you see here is caused by the stem Lorelai is on. It absorbs all the water in the vicinity. Waterzia, a water spirit, tried to stop Virgil, but he was deaf to her pleas. Virgil put her in a magic prison, so the only thing she could nourish was the stem the town was on.
They found us!
Look, this is the reason you are still alive. The book can heal itself. Listen, this arrow belongs to one of Virgil's agents. I've managed to fight them off and save you, but they took Celestia. Don't worry. Virgil cares about your sister and won't do her any harm. But he couldn't care less about us and those who live in the wild lands. Our lives are in danger. The agents also took Hector, the only one who can help us. Please, search this place for some clues. We will use them to locate Virgil's camp. Meanwhile, I'll prepare the magic mirror. I grabbed a takeover plan when one of Virgil's agents was distracted and hid it in a drawer so that no one could steal it. Better safe than sorry. Here, it's the key to my chest of drawers.
Thank you.
The path you've seen at the edge of the forest leads directly to the camp. But you'll need a magical lantern to guide you and light the way. You'd better set off. Oh, don't forget to charge the lantern. I'll stay here and protect the locals if they need it. Good luck and take care. And take this. It could come in handy.
so glad you came here to save me. Look, I'm almost sure that the cage key is somewhere in the commander's tent. But there's a problem. A guard. He's protecting the tent. Please, distract him. But be careful. We don't need extra attention now.
Thank you.
Luckily for us, Virgil's agents can't keep their mouths shut. I've learned that this camp has been here for a while. Virgil was afraid Septimia could mount a rebellion against him and decided to strike first. Virgil is ready to strike again. We must warn Septimia. That way, people will have some time to prepare for a battle. I've never been up there, in Lorelai, but a friend of mine was in Virgil's inner circle. He knows the town like the back of his hand. He can get us there and show us the way to the dungeon. We only need to find a safe way to get to his house. Please help me find my dagger and bag. These things are vital if we want to go through the marshes and survive. Hurry up. We don't want the guards to come here and put us in the cage. And take this. It may be of use.
Oh, the sweet sense of freedom. But we have one more serious challenge to face. Getting out of the marshes unscathed. This place wasn't always like this. People lived here in harmony with nature until it turned against them. The locals had to flee, and their homeland was deserted. Now we call this place the Marshes. The cave was a home for those people. Once we find it, we'll probably be able to figure out a way out of these enchanted marshes.
Is too strong. I could use your help over here.
I've seen similar stuff in my friend's books. This thing has power over plants. I guess it could come in handy. But wait, this one is slightly different. It doesn't glow. Look, one crystal is broken and the rest are missing. We must find the crystals and put them back. It's the only way we can activate the staff. Here's the plan. You look for the missing crystals, and I'll try to fix the broken one. Don't be long. We can't waste another minute. This is my friend Parsival's house. Parsival likes to bury himself in his books. When he does that, he hardly hears or notices anything around. We need to find a heavy knocker to let him know we're here. Now you can talk to Parsival, and I need to send a warning letter to Septimia. She must be ready when the enemy comes. Here, I found this outside. It may be of use.
Hello! I'm Percival. Any friend of Hector's is a friend of mine. Please, come in, you know. I used to be Virgil's scribe, but we had different views on certain matters, so he banished me from the town. Virgil has been obsessed with the idea of Lorelai being the only town in the wildlands for so long. He doesn't want to give up this stupid idea, even now when the lands are dying. To do so, he needs all the powers Wadasia has. Please, find a town plan. I took one before Virgil banished me. It must be somewhere in the house. Meanwhile, I'll look through my old books and Virgil's notes. Maybe there is a bit of information about the dungeon you're looking for. I almost forgot. There are a lot of notes about Lorelai in my old storeroom. The ones I made as Virgil's scribe. If you want to learn how the town works and functions, I'll gladly let you in there. So, what do you say? Wonderful! It's so great that someone is interested in this. Here, take it.
Thank you.
This town plan is the last copy I have. Look, I've marked down the place where the dungeon is. I could lend you my griffin, but he's been a bit edgy lately. Something is affecting him strangely. I've locked my griffin up in the barn to be on the safe side. Wait, Hector told me that you get on with animals quite well. You can have a go at taming my troubled bird. Here, this is for you. You'll need to blend in with the crowd. Virgil isn't stupid. He knows that you're coming to save Celestia. That's why I've marked the guard's cabin on the map. Go there. The cabin is the closest building to the dungeon. You'll get to your destination fast.
We're not dressed to walk the streets of Lorelai. The best way to blend in with the crowd is to become an essential part of it. The guards! We'll dress like them and sneak by unnoticed.
Thank you.
According to Parsival's map, this is the tower we've been looking for. The dungeon is somewhere in its basement, right behind these doors. We've been lucky to get here unnoticed. All the guards are along the perimeter of the town now. Virgil probably expects his enemies from the outside. That gives us a little time before someone calls the guards. So, do you have any idea of how we get into the basement?
Thank you. You saved my life. Now we can go inside. Have they left the dungeon without any guard? We'll use Virgil's overconfidence to our advantage. Celestia must be somewhere here. Let's split up. It'll speed up the search.
We need to hurry. The guards will be here any minute. I'm glad you found Celestia. Here's what I've found out. There's a secret room up there in this tower. It's Virgil's laboratory.
I think it's a great chance for us to learn more about Virgil's plans and the way Lorelai's water supply works. What do you think? Great! I've done some thinking about those weird stones and figured out the code. Here, take this.
Thank you for freeing me. I'm so worried. Virgil's insane plans put both Lorelai and the Wildlands in danger. Watersia is fading. We don't have much time left before Lorelai collapses and drags all the townspeople down. I bet Virgil knows you're in the town. He'll be here any minute. Please, find a way to defeat him and save Watersia. I'll go and get some help. Here, take this. I hope it'll be of use. Good luck. Thank you. I felt that I was at death's door.
We need to leave this place right now!
Leaving so soon? Ha! You tricked me once. This time, there is no way for you to escape.
The dagger! Fix it to fight back against Virgil!
I've spent so much time working on a fertilizer that'll allow the stem to exist without absorbing so much water. Now it's ready. Thank you, Tamer. With your help, the town is safe now, and all the lands, even the wild ones, flourish again.